How's it going, folks? How's it going? You already know what time it is, man. When you see, right, we got these cameras set up. All right, of course we got our content in the back. All right, I think actually no, that's not the newest episode, but you know, we got some Sherlock Holmes. All right, that's our recent episode of Full Game Friday, and we have some Watch Dogs too, man. But let me go ahead and set this camera up, because y'all know, man, it's Saturday, but yo, we starting it. We are starting to do something a little new, but you know what, let me stop talking, let me just set this up real quick. Hey, right, hopefully, and I know I got a whole bunch of stuff just back here, but okay, this should be good. All right, and let's go ahead and get the. Well, first off, let me get my music. I don't know if I mean, the song is decent, but let me make sure I got everything else set up though. Hold on. You know that you fire. Okay, hold up. Ooh, wait, where is it at? Okay, this is more like it. All right, DA dot that dope. Ooh, I fucked that up, but bam, we got the people, man. Listen, we have the YouTube kingdom right here, and now we finally got the kingdoms of podcasts here too, man. Hey, I just gotta say, and I know it's Saturday, y'all. Happy Saturday to everybody. For people, I mean, people typically go out or whatever, so yo, if y'all do, if anybody is out right now, listen, y'all live y'all best lives. Y'all have one hell of a time, man. All right, you know, yeah, and, but also stay safe though, because I mean, shit, COVID, and you know, hell, we still live in a world, and you know, we just gotta take precautions. But anyway, live your best life, enjoy, do what you gotta do, all right, have fun, man. But anyway, y'all already know. All right, matter of fact, I didn't even introduce myself. That's the second time I did this. All right, but anyway, y'all already know what's up. Y'all already know the waves. It is Zachariah White, a.k.a. Big Daddy Drip. Back at it like it's nothing, with this drip in the sauce, because I am the boss. I am back. We are here. We have another episode of the Royal High Table. My apologies, because this was supposed to be the third episode for the week, but it is the second. I mean, you know, we still got a whole lot of other content, all right? And don't even trip, because I'm doubling back on the double back, and I'm going to get another episode up for you guys too, all right? But, man, we got it. This is the first time that we're doing it on Saturdays too, and you know what? I'm going to spice it up a little bit, right? I did spice it up a little bit, because now I have like four telephones. I don't use all of them. Cell phones. I don't use all of them. But you know, only one of them's on. But of course, there's about some spare ones. All right. But right now, I'm using them as flashlights for the people on YouTube. You can sort of kind of see. I'm looking real Hollywood. Looking real. When I say Broadway, nah. I'm gonna say Hollywood. I'm looking real Hollywood right now, man. You know, and as far as my people on the podcast, don't worry, man. Just pull up to the YouTube and check the shit out. Alright, but you know what? Let me go ahead. Hopefully this enhances it. I'ma cut the lights off. Yo, I ain't gonna hold you. I don't quite know how it looks on cam. Hold up. I might have to spit this out. But I don't know how it looks on camera, but yo, I'ma keep it a buck. On these cameras, this shit looks fucking dope. I might have to do this shit every Saturday or every fucking week, bro. This shit is fucking lit. But anyway, I'm gonna take this out. I'm gonna spit this out. I don't say the heat talk. Okay, my fault. Okay, okay, no time to vibe to the music. But anyway, basically for you guys, y'all already know when it comes to basically the Royal High Table, y'all know we got some warm questions, some warm topics to talk about, as well as some hot topics and hot questions as well. All right, and for this particular episode, I have five warm questions, but we may not get to all of them, to be honest with you guys. And we have two topics to talk about. All right, and both of them are actually fairly recent, but the second one is really something of interest, and I'll tie it into a hot topic that we discussed, I want to say about a week or two ago. So yeah, we will get into that. Let me skip this song. The song's not, actually, nah. Wow, thoughts. okay. But anyway, man. But yeah, that's basically the wind up and the pitch for this particular episode. All right, y'all, pardon me as I just vibe and just be awkward and be weird or whatever. But before we even get into any of that, of course, it wouldn't be the Royal High Table if I didn't get into this. Everybody, y'all already know, everybody is a king or queen, god or goddess, boss, pharaoh, emperor, empress, whatever they want to call themselves. Everybody is the shit. Pardon my language. Everybody is the shit. Whether they know it or not, I don't know. Whether they know what it is that... Let me cut the volume down a little. Let me cut the volume down. Excuse me. Whether they know it or not, I don't know. Whether they know what it is that they hold control and dominion over, I mean, hell, that's what life's all about. But whenever y'all come through and y'all pull up and y'all take a seat at this table, and we chop it up, we kiki, we laugh, and we eat the bread together, we sip the wine or whatever and all that other sort of jazz, y'all make sure that y'all bring y'all crowns, all right? You bring your crowns and you wear it loud and proud for you, you wear it loud and proud for who and what you represent, and you wear it loud and proud for everybody in the world and beyond to see. All right, now with that being said, of course, let me go ahead and lead the way. Wow. I'm out here knocking stuff over. My king crown. I think tomorrow I'm gonna bust out the red one. I call that the emperor. But yo, I'm looking real slick. I was gonna say scrumptious. I don't know if that's the... I'm looking handsome. That's what I'll go with. I'm looking very dashing. You know what? But anyway, damn, this is about to fall off my head.
Hold up.
Ooh. Wow. It still might fall off my head, y'all, but anyway, I just gotta say this. I don't quite know if I said this earlier, but everybody, thank you guys so much for being here with me. Thank you guys so much for pulling up, staying tuned, you know, showing love, showing support, showing appreciation, leaving your likes, your comments, whatever. Thank you for all of that. Thank y'all so much for all of that. But of course, all good things must come to an end. Let me go ahead and put this music on pause, man. DJ Big Daddy Drip is going to have to take a little break. Fuck it, I'm going to let the beat hit. Big Fish. Little wifey, she a thick bitch. Okay. We'll save that for the break. And my apologies, of course, y'all know I'm showing up on colored people time or whatever, cause shit, I was supposed to have gotten this on and popping, you know, on and popping at about like 10. It's 11:39. But whatever, shit. It is what it is. All right, but anyway, to kick things off, and of course, y'all know, all right, before I even get into anything with any of the questions, any of the topics that I talk about, and excuse me if I'm so like hair conscious, right? I always keep playing with my hair. But for any of the topics and any of the questions that we talk about, again, you guys feel free to leave any comments, you know, regarding any it could leave your thoughts and opinions on one, you know, what you may think about, you know, what we're discussing at hand. And not only that, but leave what you think also about, you know, anything that I said. If you don't have any thoughts, you know, about the topic per se, but, you know, there's something of interest within something that I said, again, you guys feel free to make it known. You know, this is a conversation. Now, soon, I keep saying this, because at some point in time, I'm really going to branch out. It's really going to be all. It's really going to be a spectacle. I'm going to, soon enough, it's going to get to the point where I'm broadcasting this on, I'm doing, like, you know, I got my YouTube set, but there's also going to come a point in time where, on top of doing it the way that I'm doing it, I'm also going to be, you know, I'm going to have IG Live, Facebook Live, if I can, I don't know if Twitter has the, I don't know, IG Live, Facebook Live, and also try to, like, find a podcasting, I guess, podcasting source where I could, like, stream, you know, live. And shoot, hell, I might also get in Twitch, too. So, yeah, we really gonna turn this into something, all right? Even already, okay, let me get my words together. We're going to turn it into something already greater. But, again, here is where we are currently. And, again, y'all let me know just what it is that you think. But as far as the first question, the first topic or whatever, first warm question that we're going to get into tonight, all right, the first one is, if you had a friend who spoke to you in the same way that you sometimes speak to yourself, how long would you allow this person to be your friend? All right, now this is one of those, this is very interesting, all right, of course, in answering this question, whatever, one thing that does become known is, how is it that you talk to yourself? All right, how is it that you talk to yourself? How good of a friend are you to you? That's one of those underlying things that is discovered. Now, as far as for me, if I had a friend who spoke to me in the same way that I sometimes speak to myself, I would say, I mean, we'd be friends for a long time. We'd be friends for a long time. I don't think we'd split up, but I do think that there may come points and times where, shit, I might mess around and we might get into it. But I'll explain, right? Because, although, I mean, I'm not going to sit up here and act as though everything is all fine, peachy, and dandy, you know, when it comes to internal relations, me dealing with me being my own friend or whatever. But for the most part, I mean, it's very funny that that's my answer, you know, the fact that we'd be friends for a long time. But at the same time, there may be issues. But what I think, though, right? You know, when it comes to me, at least my particular case is, I am definitely my harshest critic, but I may not per se. I was about to say, but I may not be my best supporter. Basically take a look around the room and I just look at certain shit. I look at the content that I post and whatever. Hell, even that's pretty fucking difficult. that's pretty difficult for me to say. I think I do take the cake for being my biggest critic and biggest supporter. But that's the thing. I guess that's one of those things also, is because I know me more than, you know, more than anybody. So, of course, whatever fine detail, like whatever small and finer details that perhaps somebody would have overlooked, well, one, I already know what may, you know, I already know, I guess, you know, I'm up close all the issues and all the miscalculations or whatever it is that's gone wrong. I see it, I know it, and I'll hold it against me for a very long while, perhaps forever, because, you know, I guess I just use it as fuel to at least do better in the future. So keeping that in mind, if there's somebody else who's also, let me bring up a specific example, right? Because, of course, if me and said friend or whatever who is as harsh as me or talks to me in the same way that I talk to me, we will definitely get into it at points and times, because I'm definitely going to be like, you know, what the fuck is you talking? Like, yo, check your tone. Like, yo, you, hey, chill out. because I'm doing a whole bunch of, I'm doing A, B, all the way up through Z or whatever. So I know some shit done got fucked up, but hey, you better cool it and chill. Oh shit, this is about to fall off. Cool it and chill, because you know, just like a lot of shit may have gone wrong, a lot of shit did go right, and you need to pay attention to that. That's what I tell myself, and that's what I would tell the friend. But like, I guess to better illustrate this point, there is one example that I will bring up, right? I don't quite know if I've told anybody this, but I know I've definitely made a vlog about this. This was early. This was like September, October, something like that. I think it was October. But big shout outs to this organization. Shout outs to the Hispanic Latinx Student Union here on campus at FSU. But they had an event. It was their Identity Mic Night, right? And I had like, and it's funny because what drove me to get up and stand up and deliver the piece that I had wrote was the fact that I had fucked up and failed at another event. Let me get more specific about that as well, because big shout outs to the Caribbean Students Association also here at campus. They had a karaoke night, and I got up there and I was good, and I was singing a song and I was good for a good bit of the way, but I ended up fucking up at the hook, and I was like, oh shit, damn it. And every time that I mess up or something bad happens, I get on myself. I'm like, yo, what the fuck? I was in my head, yo, you should have picked a different song. not only that, I was also saying in my head, like, yo, like, again, what the fuck? Because, yo, before you got up there and sang whatever the fuck you just did, you rehearsed it in your head. Albeit three minutes before you got up there and actually did it, you rehearsed it in your head. So what the hell is going on? Why did this, you know, why is there an issue? Why did you mess it up? But that was my motivation for writing the poem and getting up and doing something, you know, for HLSU's, again, Mic Night event. And then once I went through and I delivered my piece on, you know, I delivered my poem, what's it called? Wow, my apologies, y'all. Brain fart. But I basically delivered the poem that I wrote. I got on myself. I don't know how it appears to others. I think from what everybody else told me, it was fine. They didn't notice anything off. What I know is that, like, although I had a whole bunch of rhymes, you know, there was some highlights, notable quotables or whatever, but there was 8 lines that I had that I skipped. Not because, and not because, like, I didn't skip it because, you know, I lost my place or whatever. I tried to, like, do a read of the room. Like, I like, basically, you know, I guess went over the material that I had created, and depending on the vibe of the audience, like, I guess it sort of kind of, I had these 8 lines. Well, was it 8 lines? I think it was more so 4. I think it was 4 lines that I had skipped, but it was like I was this specific part. And matter of fact, let me get even further specific, right? And I keep saying that a lot. Let me get more specific. Let me get more in detail. Within my poem, I think it should be on one of my blog sites already. But there was 8 lines in which it was influenced by, and I basically it was my alteration of Coolio's Gangster Paradise. As I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, that section, like, those 8 to 12 lines or whatever, I basically took I took those and I flipped it to talk about, you know, what it is that I was talking about, right? And I remember at that particular time, like, I had delivered the first four lines, and once I had did that, and like, I read, I was trying to like read the energy of the room, and it wasn't, I wasn't feeling like it was it. To me, in my head, I was like, nah, that's not it. We could go ahead and scrap it, right? But then I went to the end, and I didn't deliver the end as strong as as I had went over it, as I had it constructed in my head, and as I had practiced it out, you know, the week or couple days, not the week, but the couple of days leading up to the event. So like for that particular instance, I was very hard on myself, like, yo, what the fuck? That's another time that you fucked up. And I'm gonna keep it all the way a buck. Although I had originally planned on doing this, those fuck ups are just say that they are a reason why next semester I'm pulling up and I'm showing out for both of their pageants. But anyway, right? Again, for both of those instances, I held myself accountable, to say the least. And so I think that, like, for instances like that, had there been like another voice also echoing that same sentiment, one, I don't think that the way that I feel about it now, I just feel that same way, because, like, I think that, you know, that particular friend, I might be like, you know what, fuck that, bro, this shit, it was, I know that I fucked up, but it was still good, bro, shut the fuck up and get the fuck off my back. That's how I would sort of kind of be. So, but nonetheless, though, I think also I do try to take note and keep in mind everything, especially, you know, stuff that, you know, I try to take note and keep an eye and keep, I just pay attention for the veggies as well as the dessert. So that's one of those reasons why, again, to relate it back to my overall response to the question, I'd be friends with that person for a very long time. But yeah, we probably get into a hell of a lot of times. That's my answer. And I almost forgot this part, you guys. All right. Of course, you guys. This is not in relation to the question. This is in relation to the podcast, of course, man. It's for my people here on YouTube. Y'all already know, man. My camera be fucking up, it don't be fucking up. It just records in 30-minute intervals, so y'all know that I'm gonna have that out. And then, of course, as far as the recorder for the podcast, I'm also going to split basically the audio up into sections, so that for sure, it is within range. You know, it's within range for Anchor, Spotify, and Sounder to basically, you know, take and just receive the audio without it being too much, all right? But of course, we also got this camera right here that's gonna catch all the fine bits, all right? But anyway, enough with that, right? Let's go ahead and jump on to the next question, all right? I guess before anything cuts off, all right? The next question that I have is... Wow, okay, I'll jump to this one. I like this one. I like what I have for number three. Let me stop stuttering. I've been doing that a lot this week. I do not know what's up. My fault, you guys. But a question that I have is, would you rather be a worried genius or a joyful simpleton? Right? Oh yeah, and by the way, these also come from Bucket List Journey. So, yo, big shout outs to Bucket List Journey. Alright? But as far as this particular question, would you rather be a worried genius or a joyful simpleton? I think this is very, very easy. This is very easy. Alright? I would be a worried genius. And I feel like to some degree, I am a worried genius in the sense that there are instances, basically this question, just at its, like, I guess, fundamental base, is one of those Would you rather, I guess, have a greater ability, but also, have a greater ability that comes with responsibility, or would you rather, like, just rather not have that ability, but things be, you know, I guess, as put in the question, like, simple, you know, you not have no ability, okay, have... Would you rather have an ability with responsibility or have no ability with no responsibility, right? That's a rough summation of the question, right? And as far as recent times, I've spent most of the years being a worried genius as opposed to a joyful simpleton. So being a worried genius just comes natural. Not only that, I think here's my thing also. Also, like, just as I, like, read the question just not too long ago, and as I was, as I had picked it off from the website before I cut the cameras on, I was thinking of a Bruce Lee quote. And I don't, like, this is not verbatim, but essentially what he stated was, I do not, like, don't pray for an easy life, but pray for, I guess, the ability, the strength to withstand a hard life. And that's something that I heard, you know, that's something that, you know, I hear that. That's something that I really stand with. That's something that I support. That's what I like. I mean, I don't necessarily want an easy life. Well, I'll say this, right? And I'll try and bring it back to the question. Do I want an entirely easy life? No. Do I want it to be all hard, all whatever? No. I think this is, I guess, my philosophy, you know, the philosopher Big Daddy Drip kicking in. But I don't want it to, life, at least for me, to be overly hard or overly easy, but there to be a reasonable mix, right? And or at the very least, there to be the tailored combination for me, right? And I guess let me even further explain that. Whatever ingredients, however life is going to be, I want it to be basically enough of whatever ingredients that must be there and will be there and ought to be there and should be there. Enough of those ingredients as to whereas it's ultimately what's in the best interest, right? And what's best for me. So, but nonetheless, So that's more so as far as that particular response. I think it's one of those in between answers of it's one of those. Well, let me get a little bit of this and a little bit of that. It's one of those, again, gray area answers, right? But to, I guess, relay it and try and, you know, translate it back to the question, I think I would rather be a worried genius. All right, and more so, I would rather, again, take the hard life as opposed to the easy life. I think just more so when it comes back to looking back on it, I'll come to appreciate and enjoy and respect the fact that there were a number of different challenges that I had to go through, a number of different hard times, a number of different, I guess, opponents to battle, you know. And I don't quite necessarily mean like physical people. I mean, like, you know, situations, you know, maybe overall, I'll say concepts, you know, I'll say, you know, spirits even, you know. I think more so I'd be that worried genius. I don't quite know. I mean, I think I'm, well, obviously got to be smart enough to get to college and all that, but I don't know. I think I might be on the genius side. I'd be more close to the genius than the simpleton, even in that respect also. But, you know, hey, ho, it's a little something. But let me check where my camera is at real quick, you guys. Okay, now, yo, my camera's gonna cut out in a little bit, all right? My people on YouTube, y'all, don't trip. The camera's gonna cut out, but we are going to get it on and popping again. We gonna run it back. We gonna spin the block and keep it going. Ooh, my shit is falling. Hold up. All right. But, ooh. Wow, it's gonna cut off in a little bit, but I'll see y'all then. Or see y'all in the next one, all right? Peace.